It's not official yet because we're only like over a week in, but it looks like the Warriors messed up again in the draft. Last year, drafting James Wiseman over LaMelo Ball. This year, drafting Kuminga and Moody over one of our top five rookies so far. The whole idea of not trading the young guys was to win now in Steph Curry's prime. Well, we've seen how good all of these rookies have been so far. Moody sent to the G League. Kuminga debuted for like 6 minutes and we have no idea if he'll make an impact this year. Kuminga has a lot of ground to make up to be as good as the guy they should have drafted. I know it's early, but we can say who the best NBA rookies have been so far. Before we get to our top five rookies so far, we have to mention, yes, it is really early. These rankings could look completely different by the end of the year, but we love basketball and this is what we do, right? I mean, in 5 years, the rankings will definitely look different. But some guys you can just tell right away they belong in the NBA. And some guys you can tell they just don't. Like for example, we could tell early on, Killian Hayes probably isn't ready for the NBA, and we are still waiting for him to prove us wrong. Cade Cunningham had just 2 points in his debut, but it doesn't matter. It's just one game. Jalen Suggs, though, has been awful. I know he scored like 13 points per game, but 30% from the field, he's been a huge negative for Orlando. I am not judging him yet because he is a rookie guard and I think rookie guards take a long time to develop, but the Raptors look real smart drafting Scottie Barnes. Honorable mention of good rookies goes to Austin Reeves of the Lakers, the new white guy in LA. Who needs Alex Caruso? Actually, the Lakers really do need Alex Caruso. Yeah. But Reeves is averaging over 6 points. Not that there's a lot of offense to go around on that team, so 6 points is impressive. I just really like his passing and how an undrafted rookie is like not intimidated at all to be on the same court as like Russell Westbrook, LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony. The dude goes out there every night like, yeah, I belong here. That's amazing. But our number five rookie so far, Jalen Green. I love Jalen's skill set. He can play on or off the ball. Obviously a great scorer. One day, he's going to be one of the best offensive players in basketball. And I don't really care that he's disappointed in most of his games. He's a rookie, but he's got it. You can just tell. He belongs in the league. The reason he's number five, though, on this list is horrible on defense, really inefficient. He had 0 free throw attempts his first 4 games. I said on draft night, the Rockets messed up not drafting Evan Mobley, and I still believe that. But other rookies have looked a lot better than Green, not just Mobley. And that starts with number 4, Josh Giddey. The 6th pick for the Thunder. A lot of people thought it was a reach. So far, not at all. They nailed the pick. 19 years old, 28 minutes a game, 11 points, 6 boards, 6 assists. I know it's easier to rack up numbers on a bad team, but dropping 18 points and 10 assists against the Lakers is tough for any 19-year-old. I don't care what team you're on. The only player younger to get 10 dimes in a game was LeBron James himself. I think part of the reason people thought that the Thunder reached at number 6 for this kid was that he is so young, but I think it's pretty clear that he's already played 1 pro season overseas, right? Like, that type of experience matters. We saw it with LaMelo Ball too. I think his scoring ability and passing ability at 6'8" is super rare. Now, the Thunder took him right before Golden State could, so this guy is not who Golden State should have taken. They didn't have the chance. But he's still making sure to make, you know, connections in the Bay. Random thought, by the way. Could Josh Giddey be, eventually, the best Aussie ever in NBA history? I don't consider Kyrie Australian, by the way. Giddey would have to beat Luke Longley, Andrew Bogut, Joe Ingles, Patty Mills, and Ben Simmons. That's a high bar. But I think he's got a shot. Our number 3 best rookie so far has been Chris Duarte, and this is who Golden State should have taken at number 7. Duarte has contributed right away because he is experienced at 24 years old, one of the oldest rookies in the draft. He is leading rookies in minutes, 2nd in points, top 6 assists, 39% from 3, 91% from the line. He is like a vet role player from day one. He can also play on or off the ball. You know exactly what Golden State needs. Steph Curry is playing like an MVP, but Duarte would be an amazing fit on this team right now. We don't know what these rookies are going to look like in 5 years, but in 5 years, we know what Golden State's core is going to look like old. You need someone who can impact the game right now. That is who Duarte is. The Dubs missed on his instant impact, so they whiffed in the draft. You know who didn't? The Pacers. Our number two rookie this year, Evan Mobley. His stats aren't as good as Duarte, but Mobley is a beast on both ends. He got 10 blocks his first 7 games. That is more than double any other rookie. And it's not all at the rim either. This kid blocks jump shots. He's already guarding 1 through 5. Do you know how rare that is in the NBA? Now, I was worried about the fit with Jarrett Allen at first, but so far, Mobley is versatile enough to play the 4 at 7 feet tall. And Jarrett Allen's having his best season yet because of it. Honestly, the Cavs are my favorite young team to watch so far, and Mobley is a huge reason why. And the reason I think the Rockets should have drafted him, and maybe the Pistons too at this point, is Mobley's skill set is like impossible to find. He is what Kevin Durant invented, the term a unicorn, right? The only 3 big men, I think, versatile on both ends. Like, they have some range, they can guard 1 through 5, they can handle the ball, the whole thing, is Giannis, KD, and Anthony Davis. Easily 3 of the best players in the NBA. Let's say Mobley becomes like a poor man's version of any of those, then he's a legit piece on the next Cavs championship. But even better than him is Scottie Barnes. And honestly, I was dead wrong about Scottie Barnes and maybe the entire Raptors as a team because of him. I thought he was gonna be like a project that needed to refine his game, but Barnes is a beast. He leads all rookies in points and rebounds. He's efficient at 55% from the field, pretty good at the line, 71%, with great defense. Now, I love how confident this kid is. It's almost like he heard all the people laughing at the Raptors for making that pick and just wanted to shut them all up, which is what he has done. Now the Raptors have a winning record without Pascal Siakam. Imagine how good they're gonna be when he comes back. They could be a top 6 seed where I thought they were gonna miss the playoffs altogether. Now, I thought that Scottie Barnes would be one of those like glue guys that did all the little things that don't show up in the box score, like all the hustle plays, but he is their leading scorer. Who goes from 10 points a game in college to 18 points a game leading your NBA team as a rookie? Who does that? We knew he was a good passer as a point forward coming in from the draft, and he is aggressive, but he has been the number one rookie so far out of nowhere. Okay, so that's who I think the best rookies have been, but what about the actual rookie of the year odds? These are the latest odds. Jalen Green, still the favorite at plus 310. Scottie Barnes, Cade Cunningham, Evan Mobley, all at plus 500. Josh Giddey next at plus 650. Chris Duarte all the way at plus 900. I think that is crazy. I think Jalen Green should be way down the list, but it's obvious that the people who make these odds are expecting Jalen Green to get rolling once he gets things figured out and just pop. Another thing I noticed if you look at the odds, it's basically those 6 guys in the Rookie of the Year race. Jalen Suggs is at plus 1700, not even in the picture. And if you wanna see a picture of who's been like the best and worst starters, like forget rookies, check this video out because it shows so far who the best player has been, who the worst player is, and I did not expect who the worst player actually is.